Let's talk about your own year, first year away from inter-county action. I know you've been injured in the past, but first full year away where you haven't been involved. What was it like for you standing on the sidelines watching?
It was different. So it's been one of those things where, you know, when I wasn't able to commit and when I chose to step away, it was something that I really had to understand and think about, because I absolutely loved playing for Limerick. So when you can't commit that time, I wanted to commit time to my family. I wanted to commit time to my small boys, my little girl, my wife. You know, I wanted to commit more time there. My job is taken on natural. So all those naturally occurring things would have softened the blow for me, because I would have had such a myriad of different things to pour myself into. Loved going to the games, brought my small lady to the Munster final, the league final. She absolutely loved it. I was in Croke Park for the semi-final. Tough one, but that was actually the hardest one of them all. But that was more to do with, I don't know, whatever it was, just tense before the game, during the game, after the game.
Do you think there was anything with how, you know, Limerick were just unbelievable throughout the latter stages of the league, throughout the Munster Championship, you know, beat everyone well, obviously didn't put out a full team against Tipperary the first day, so I discount that. But do you think there's any sense that the way Limerick are playing, do you know, that sort of working the ball out from the back and then finding Aaron in space, or maybe Graham Mulcahy or Peter Casey, that this year teams had so much footage to study what Limerick were doing, that maybe kind of doing the same thing over and over, bringing back the wing forwards back so far, that other teams learned a little bit about this Limerick team?
Yeah. So there's no maybe, that teams definitely learned more about Limerick because they were paying more attention to them. So there's that. I think that's a given. And it would have actually, you'd seen, so despite the high levels that they reached in the league and at times in the Munster Championship, you could see then there was games where they came up against something like the Cork game, where, we'll say, Cork's willingness to go out the field with the half forwards and to man up, man to man on the full forward line and nullify them. That was something that, you know, a lot of teams don't try, and if they do try, it really requires a superb effort from their full back line. So they saw different things that they probably did struggle with at different times, but ultimately they won the league final at a canter. They won the Munster final at a canter, playing exceptional stuff. And it's really, really important to remember the levels that with Limerick played to this year. I think they were, you know, outside of in the last 45 years since 1973, this is the second best year they've had. So it's something perspective that'll probably get lost in time, or it could get lost in time. But it's probably why the semi-final is as disappointing as it was. Is because, you know, they had form, they've had mental fortitude as their hallmark for the last 2 years, especially after that performance in the Munster final. They really kind of brought a level of intensity, tackling, and, you know, just concentration and focus that, you know, that left Tipperary flailing in the second half. But I suppose that was probably the most disappointing element of the semi-final, is that when Kilkenny brought what Limerick would have been normally depending on, and, you know, we did. I think the it was balanced towards the end of the first half, start of the second half, and even obviously the momentum gained towards the end of the second half with Shane's goal, David Reedy's point, you know. But we didn't score after that, and that was a really disappointing thing to close out a game. I felt that Kilkenny were superbly intelligent to close that out.
Do you think there was any element that there was a false reality from that Tipperary game, because Tip's full back line has changed massively since then? Bonner Maher wasn't available, Cathal Barrett wasn't available, Niall O'Mara was only able to come on at half time. So do you think there's anything whereby the team thought they were in an even better place than they looked?
I find it difficult, especially with the management team that they have, and we'll say the analysis that they would have done after the game. So regardless of what they played against Tipperary on that day, that was a really top class hurling performance. So you take, and no one been in that video analysis room, you take the measurables and the actual, you know, the tangibles from that, and that's what you take and learn from the next day. You don't take the hype, and you don't take, but, you know, it's All Ireland semi-final is a big day. It's a huge day, and it's disappointing, especially when it's like, you know, I probably the preoccupation with TJ didn't do us any favors,
because bringing back Tom Morris, or Kyle Hayes,
you know, listen, but like, I think John did that with the best of intentions of nullifying a strength, but unfortunately our half hour line for Limerick is, it's just so much a part of what we do, and for them they need to be firing and functioning, and then to take one third of that and put it in a different role, it probably does affect the balance of the team. But not to the point where, you know, where you've you know, 13 wides and you know, some of them from standing positions. So like that's a purely mental thing. Mm. So is it a question of a false reality? Probably not. But just I would say it's a question of execution on the day and managing the expectation probably.
And one final question then, briefly. Yeah. Will Limerick be back next year challenging for an All-Ireland?
There will be, because like the so if you look at 18 and I was a firm believer in this, 18 wasn't our peak. You know, 19 has actually delivered more memorable and high level performances than 18 did if you actually look back through it. So I would expect, especially the trajectory of the players involved, that 2020 will be hugely competitive. They'll be very, very difficult to beat, and doing the same thing again, like Kilkenny did the same thing for 8, 10 years in a row, and I don't think anybody found a way to stop them in any meaningful way outside of Tipperary in 2010. So you know, it's, you know, if you find what you're doing, do it well, and expect somebody else to try and stop it.
Thanks very much, James.
Yeah, one.